Let's talk now about the production methods available for growing crops without disturbing your soil any more than necessary. Your soil will remain healthy and productive only if you keep your tillage to a minimum. Remember, the organic matter and soil structure you're working so hard to generate can't tolerate very much disturbance.
It took years and years in a system that's been disrupted, the soil has been disrupted. Now you have to fix it and you have to repair it. But if you learn how it works and how the soil functions, then you start realizing that the equipment is an important part, but the most important critical thing is your thinking process. And then the tools are not the focus, but the understanding is the focus, and the tools are to carry out your understanding.
In the southeastern United States, row crop farmers generally rely on two production systems, no-till and strip-till. Each method has advantages, depending on the kind of soil on your farm and the crops you grow. As the name says, the no-till system for producing crops leaves farm soils virtually undisturbed and uses lower horsepower equipment so it can give you the greatest fuel savings. In no-till, seeds are planted in a narrow slot created by an opener after a coulter cuts through the surface residue. No-till farming can create some challenges. Because surface residue covers the entire field, including the crop row, your soil may be slower to warm up in the spring. During cool, wet springs, you'll need to be flexible about the time you choose to plant the crop. Strip tilling involves removing the surface residue from a narrow strip of soil and then tilling only a narrow slot in that strip. Generally speaking, strip tilling leads to higher seed germination rates than no-till because of improved seed-to-soil contact and warmer soil temperatures. The strip-till system also allows you to band fertilizer. It can also give you a short-term remedy for compacted soils because you're able to loosen deeper soils through subsoiling. This allows you to break up an underlying hard pan that prevents root penetration and water infiltration. The production methods required by strip-till are more expensive than no-till. You'll need a tractor with adequate horsepower, and there's also the capital cost of any necessary toolbars and tillage equipment. Strip-tilling, though it disturbs the soil much less than conventional methods, still damages soil structure and biology. You'll be undoing some of the benefits you're working to achieve. Remember, both no-till and strip-till systems are far superior to the conventional tillage methods.
So it's a beautiful system because it's limiting disturbance, physical, chemical, and biological disturbance. And I thought that was a really profound thing a professor told me. Farming's nothing less than managing disturbance.
Remember all the good things that plant residues do for your soil.
But this is what it's all about to me right here, this residue on the ground. And you know, through the years, we have farmers say, well, this is trash farming. We're finding out that this trash is really what's so beneficial to us. As this residue breaks down, this is where we get the buildup of our organic matter and our organic carbon. Not only does it build our soil quality, you can see it suppresses the weeds that may be coming up, but it also holds moisture in the soil too. Here in South Georgia, we go through extended droughts, and we need all the help we can keeping moisture in the field.
Planning and managing surface residue goes hand in hand with the work you do to reduce tillage. Managing plant residues will become part of your overall strategy for building healthy soil. As you plan your crop rotation and choose cover crops, think about the kinds and the amounts of surface residue you want to leave behind for the upcoming crop. Heavy corn stalks make excellent overwinter residue. Residues from finer plants like soybeans do much less to protect the soil. It's important to distribute surface residue evenly throughout your field. Harvesting equipment should not leave plant material in piles or rows. Your combine will need a spreader that distributes the residue evenly. Deep piles of residue can plug your planting equipment, and cool, damp residue piles will delay seed germination. Finally, be sure that every part of your field is covered by the surface residue. You can get more information on managing surface residue from NRCS Conservation Standard number 329.